Hello students, in this video I'll be discussing about how to convert vector in the Cartesian form to the cylindrical polar coordinates or the spherical polar coordinates. To begin with, let me consider a vector f given by zi minus xj plus yk. Express f in cylindrical polar coordinates. To begin with, we first write the expressions for the unit vectors in the cylindrical polar coordinates. For that, we have x equal to rho cos theta, y equal to rho sine theta, which are the parametric substitutions for a circle, and z will remain z. So with the three variables x, y, z expressed in terms of rho, theta and z, we have the cylindrical polar coordinates. So we have vector r to be rho cos theta I cap plus rho sine theta j cap plus z k cap. Now the unit vector e rho is obtained by differentiating vector r with respect to rho. So we have cos theta I cap plus sin theta j cap. Now e theta is obtained by differentiating r with respect to theta, and we find that the base vector, the scale factor, is equal to rho, so which we have to divide with. So we have minus sin theta I cap plus cos theta j cap. So if you observe, e theta is obtained by differentiating r with respect to theta, then dividing with rho throughout, and ez will be k cap. So we have e rho, e theta and ez in terms of cos theta, sin theta and the unit vectors I, j and k. If required, this can be written in terms of matrix form. As e rho, e theta, e z, equal to cos theta sin theta 0 minus sin theta cos theta 0 0 0 1 I, J, K. The beauty about this coefficient matrix, cos theta sin theta 0 minus sin theta cos theta 0, 0, 0 and 1, is that it is an orthogonal matrix. That means A inverse is equal to A transpose. So if you want I, J, K in terms of E rho, E theta and E z, all we have to do is multiply this column vector with the transpose of this कोएफिशिएंट मैट्रिक्स। Now we require vector f in terms of rho, theta and z. Now f, that is we require f equal to f1 e rho plus f2 e theta plus f3 e z. Now f dot e rho is f1, f dot e theta is f2, f dot e z is f3. So we can use this concept to arrive at the expressions for f1, f2 and f3. So f is equal to zi minus x is rho cos theta j plus y is rho sin theta k. So if I call this equations 1, so using 1, f1 equal to zi minus rho cos theta j plus rho sin theta k dot e rho, that is cos theta I plus sin theta j. So f1 will be z cos theta minus rho cos theta sin theta. Similarly, f2 equal to zi minus rho cos theta j plus rho sin theta k dot minus sin theta I plus cos theta j, which gives us minus z sin theta minus rho cos squared theta. And finally f3 is zi minus rho cos theta j plus rho sin theta k dot k, which is rho sin theta. So vector f is, we have found f1, so z, z minus rho sin theta into cos theta e rho minus z sin theta plus rho cos squared theta e theta plus rho sin theta e z. So this vector, the given vector has been expressed in terms of the cylindrical polar coordinates rho, theta and z. Now we perform a similar exercise on this vector in terms of spherical polar coordinates. So we have x, y, and z. We start with the expression for z, which is rho cos theta. So x will be r sine theta cos phi, y will be r sine theta sine phi. So vector r will be r sine theta cos phi I cap plus r sine theta sine phi j cap plus r cos theta k cap. So the unit vectors in terms of spherical polar coordinates will be er cap, which is the derivative of r vector r with respect to r. So we have sine theta cos phi I cap plus sine theta sine phi j cap plus cos theta k cap. Now e theta is obtained by differentiating vector r with respect to theta, and the scale factor is r. Therefore, eliminate r and differentiate vector r with respect to theta. That gives us cos theta cos phi I cap plus cos theta sine phi j cap minus sine theta k cap. And E phi is obtained by differentiating vector r with respect to phi. The scale factor will be r sine theta. So we have minus sine phi I cap plus cos phi j cap. Now if we write these three expressions as a matrix multiplication, again it results in an orthogonal matrix. So to obtain ijk, all we have to do is make use of inverse of matrix. Since this we have an orthogonal matrix, A inverse will be the same as A transpose. Now we want vector f, which is yi plus zj minus x squared k in terms of the spherical coordinates. So this will be r sine theta sine phi I cap plus r cos theta j cap minus r squared sine squared theta cos squared phi k cap. Now vector f dot er will be f1. So f1 is r sine squared theta sine phi cos phi plus r sine theta sine phi cos theta minus r squared sine squared theta cos squared phi cos theta. If f dot e theta is f2, so f2 is equal to r sine theta sine phi cos theta cos phi plus r cos theta r cos squared theta sine phi plus r squared sin cube theta cos squared phi. Now f dot e phi is f3, so we have minus r sin theta sin squared phi plus r cos theta cos phi. So we will number these. We'll call this as 1, this as 2, and this as 3. So vector f is f1 e rho plus f2 e theta plus f3 e phi, where f1, f2 and f3 are given by equations 1, 2 and 3.